Activity-based costing. Topic three, ABC versus other costing systems. This short video will act as a wrap-up to ABC costing, which will really lead us into the next part of the semester. We have gone through a review of our prerequisite material. We have looked at job costing. We have looked at cost volume profit analysis. We've looked at activity-based costing. These are all methods in which we can solve different types of problems. The next two chapters will really encourage you to pull from those buckets of tools to solve problems for your users. So let's wrap up this chapter so that we can go on and solve bigger and better problems together. So a friendly reminder that activity-based costing is an alternative, one alternative of a tool that you can use. So let's consider the arguments for and against the use of a relatively simple costing system with a single predetermined overhead rate and an activity-based costing system. ABC systems are costly to implement, as well as maintain, but they do provide the highest quality of costing information. Conversely, a single rate system, those are relatively inexpensive, relatively easy to implement and maintain, but they do provide less useful costing information than their ABC alternative. So, when should you implement an ABC activity-based costing system? So, they aren't always required, but here are some typical signs that an ABC system could benefit the company. Perhaps if you have staff who disagree regularly on the costs of manufacturing products. And this is worsened if compensation is tied to cost-based metrics, right? Because we want to have accurate information so that people feel like their input of effort is rewarded, both in recognition of the output, but also recognized in monetary ways. Perhaps products that the company produces regularly don't show significant profitability, but new products that are produced less commonly show significant profits. This could indicate inaccurate costing. That would be because if they produce it regularly, they likely have the processes streamlined, and if the company overall is profitable, then perhaps there's some cross-subsidization in play here. Okay, what about if most indirect costs can be considered output unit level costs, meaning they are not product sustaining costs, facility costs, etc. And another last example or scenario of when ABC systems could benefit a company would be when there are a significant amount of current costs being allocated on a basis with only very few cost pools. So this would be indicative of inaccurate costing as you have a lot of costs and very little pools allocated to them. Remember, you want to have small little pools and really tie the cause and effect of what is driving the cost to go in those pools to make sure you allocate them appropriately. ABC could also be used as a basis for product mix decisions. So as costing for a company becomes more accurate, it allows for better strategic decisions to be made. For example, when companies are regularly trying to determine the effects of the company by adding or dropping a product, hint, hint, we're going to see that in future chapters. There are other benefits to this information as well, as accurate costing can allow for better price setting. For example, if you are trying to outcompete a competitor by lowering costs, ABC will help you find the most accurate costing system for you to base your pricing decisions on, such that you are able to price your products competitively low, but not to the point where you're selling it at a loss. All right, let's look at a question. You are considering the likely costing systems of a number of businesses. Which business is most likely to use an ABC system? Would it be A, a lemonade stand, B, a nail manufacturer that makes one model of nail, C, a large aircraft manufacturer, or D, a tailor shop where the owner is the only employee? If you answered C, a large aircraft manufacturer, you are correct. When determining what types of businesses are suitable for an ABC system, the needs of the business must be considered. A lemonade stand is highly simplistic and unlikely to need an ABC system. Similarly, a company with only one product, like a nail manufacturer, is unlikely to need the ABC system. There wouldn't be any cross-product subsidization. A tailor shop that is owner-operated likely doesn't need have the capacity to perform all the data collection and tracking to run an ABC system. Whereas a large aircraft manufacturer is likely to have the business need as well as the funds to deploy the ABC system. All right. Fantastic work. We are more than halfway through the material that will be examined on term test number one. I want to thank you so much for your hard work, and I hope you have an excellent week. Before I sign off, please do try out the tutorial questions and then watch the videos and see how well you did. Feel free to email me any questions or let me know how it's going. All right, have a good week. Bye.